Good time of year. Very exciting for the players to get into the competitive season. They put in a lot of work as far as weight room, training, all of those types of things. It's a challenge for us as coaches for the next 10 days, 2 weeks, to keep them focused on improving, which that'll be a big point of emphasis. We have a lot of work that we still need to do prior to getting to next Friday, but then at that point, you know, we'll probably be where we can't improve anymore until we get to see somebody else in the other dugout, which we're real excited about. Great non-conference schedule with a lot of teams that were in the NCAA tournament or conference championship teams from a year ago that will test us. But there's a lot to feel good about, a lot of returning players with a lot of at-bats that are better than they were a year ago. Some guys that were hoping to take that next step in their development, mesh all together and figure out our best team and go out and compete really hard, you know, in a way that we want our program to be known for. So we're very excited to get going next week.
Reedus was named with many honors recently. What does it say about him, and how do you think it'll impact the team?
First off, those types of things, whether it's rankings, preseason honors, are all validation of good performance in the past. And Alfonso certainly had a great season last year, probably, in my opinion, one of the most underrated players in the country. In terms of his qualities as a player, he has as good a plate discipline as any college hitter you will see. His ability to hit mistakes is as good as any hitter that you will see at this level. And the thing I appreciate the most about him is his mental maturity. He's very consistent, you know, never too high or too low, and that allows him to perform at a high level on a consistent basis. And he's really a model in that regard that we want all of our hitters to get to.
What have you learned about your team since spring practice started?
Like I said, we still have some work to do, and it's more tangible, fundamental stuff as opposed to how all the pieces fit. I think there's been some clarity come to light in the last 2 weeks in terms of that. We've focused on, as we always do, the process of what it takes to win a Division I baseball game. You know, there's been a lot of good things and a lot of things that we need to continue to improve on. But the personnel, I think we've learned a lot as far as how some of the pieces are going to roll out originally, which is good. And it should be that way when you have some older players in the program that have had some previous experience and successful experience. So there's some good foundational pieces, and I think we've learned a lot about that here in the last couple weeks.
How close are you to figuring out what the pitching staff might look like, at least early in the season?
I think we're getting closer. I think this weekend will be important. You know, we've had a lot of guys have a good outing, you know, or two. I'd like to see this weekend to evaluate the consistency and how that gets rolled out. I think at the front of it, you know, we have a few experienced pitchers that have all taken a step forward in their development. And I think Coach Lawn deserves a lot of credit with that. Michael Flynn has pitched very well the last 2 weeks, and everything is there in terms of velocity, multiple pitches for strikes, you know, and so he'll obviously figure in heavily to what we're doing. We've talked before about Tyler McGill's improvement in his body conditioning, delivery, mental maturity. I think he's come a long ways and will definitely be heavily involved in what we do. Cody Deason, same thing, has really progressed well, and I'm very pleased with that. You know, it's three right-handers, a couple left-handers. Randy LeBeau had a very good outing last weekend, had a good fall for us in terms of throwing strikes. And when he did that last year, he was very effective against some really good teams. So, again, the consistency piece of that is what we're continuing to look for from him. Avery Weems had a great outing last weekend and has really taken some maturity steps since we've been back. You know, and then there's some guys, and I mentioned this before, last year, that have also taken some step forwards. Juan Aguilera is probably a guy that I should have used a little bit more last year, and late in the year, He helped us out in some key spots. I think you'll see him factor into things. Robbie Medel, who numbers-wise had a very good season when you stacked all of it up together, will figure into it. And then there's some freshman pitchers that we really like. Jonathan Guardado comes to mind in terms of stuff, explosiveness, maturity. He is a winner. You know, had a very good high school year last year in terms of wins, losses, numbers. Gil Luna is a lefty that has a good arm. Ball comes out of his hand great. Josh Haley, pitchability guy. And then, again, there's a lot of competition. You know, beyond that, Austin Nichols coming off Tommy John surgery. I mean, it's an athletic delivery, a fast arm. Ryan Gallins has improved a lot. I'm hesitant to leave anybody out. Jason Seaver is another left-handed pitchability guy that had to sit out last year due to transfer rules. Preston Price has a good arm. We're just looking for that consistency out of him. Really good fastball. So it's still a work in progress, and jobs are up for the taking. A guy like Zach Sherman, who redshirted last year, you know, has been, you know, in the 89-91 with good sink on his ball and multiple pitches for strikes. So it's a good battle. You're going to see a lot of guys roll out of the bullpen early on in the season, and the goal is to play well enough to where we can have some success in terms of winning some games while figuring out what our best team is. I always believe that to be really important, and this year's no different. What's the